Boa noite. Gostaria de continuar falando da imunidade e queria saber se tem algum consenso, já foi levantada a hipótese de que há uma diferença entre você receber uma carga viral alta ou baixa do coronavírus, que isso faria diferença no desenvolvimento da doença e no desenvolvimento da imunidade. Então, eu gostaria de saber se já existe algum consenso nesse sentido, né? Se receber menos vírus causa uma doença menos grave e a imunidade gerada pela doença já se sabe se ela é de longa duração, se a duração da imunidade tem uma relação direta com a carga viral recebida.
That's an important question. I was among the first to raise the idea of viral dosimetry in an article that I wrote originally in the New Yorker and then subsequently in many interviews. The answer is we don't know, and we in the middle of the pandemic, it is impossible to measure. Now, for many other viruses, including measles, there is a relationship between the dose of the virus that you receive, the chance that you will get infection, and the severity of the infection. We do not know this for coronavirus. But what we do know is that this is true for several other respiratory viruses. And in fact, the mechanism by which we can prevent receiving higher doses of virus at the first place is, of course, to do one. Number one is to keep a social distance. And number two is to wear masks, which may not reduce the entire dose of the virus, but may reduce it tenfold or even more, depending on the kind of mask that you wear. So, based on previous experiences with other respiratory viruses, we have thought think we think that it's likely that whether or not you get an infection has something to do with the amount of virus that you actually get exposed to. But there is no direct study that I know of in coronavirus. The indirect studies would suggest that this might be the case, because one thing that you might know is that people who are getting exposed to very high doses of the virus, such as frontline healthcare workers, doctors and nurses, even young doctors and nurses are succumbing or have succumbed to a very severe variant of the disease. Now, this is not proof, this is an incidental finding, but even, you remember right from the beginning, even in Wuhan, the ophthalmologist who first described the cases of coronavirus ultimately died of coronavirus infection. So this is not direct proof. We don't have a kind of controlled study, but the evidence, if you look at the evidence, especially looking at frontline healthcare workers who receive very high doses of virus because they are seeing patients who are very sick and are emitting higher doses of virus. The fact that even young frontline workers have died in this would suggest that that the dose of the virus has something to do with the chances of getting the infection and with the severity of infection. But that said, we do not have direct evidence that that is the case.